Hey there, my name is Kriana, and I'm here to talk to you about what is so awesome about our new program, Ecstatic Awakening Yoga. By our, I mean Torrin Collective, if you don't know who we are yet. So I'm sure you've heard that before. Oh, this yoga is awesome, that yoga is awesome. But I really mean, with all of the cells in my being, that this yoga is unlike anything that you've ever experienced before. And the reason is because, well, let me ask you a few questions first. When you've taken a yoga class, have you ever felt through the asana practice that some things came to the surface and it was inappropriate to express whatever it was that was coming up? Because there is that sort of energy, that taboo in yoga classes that you can't make noise, even sighing loudly, people might look at you funny. There's a lot of pressure to be quiet, stay focused, because I think, you know, I don't know why that happened, but maybe because people get distracted by other people making noises. Have you ever been in Shavasana at the end of your practice and had crazy sensations in your body, like your heart beating wildly or feeling a lot of energy running through you and not knowing what to do? I've heard people say that they feel that they thought maybe something was wrong with them or physically and felt concerned about the things that were coming up. I've heard people say that after a certain type of yoga asana practice that they feel agitated and don't go back to doing the practice because it brought so much up and they had so much angst, anxiety, anger, rage, whatever it was that doing the poses brought to the surface was uncomfortable and there was no training whatsoever about what to do with those energies. So that's what Ecstatic Awakening Yoga is here to accomplish. This is a combination of myself and my work that I have brought forward using some ancient techniques, just like making noises. I mean, some of this stuff is really what should be in the manual on how to be human. Making noises, tapping, shaking, just curling into a ball even, expressing whatever it is that's coming to the surface and releasing it so that you're not stuffing it. And we call this Ecstatic Awakening Meditation. And what we've done is combined it with a yoga asana practice that my husband, Maka Lumen, is bringing. He is an amazing, very experienced yoga teacher in both the Iyengar and Ashtanga lineages, and he is excellent at alignment. So what he'll be doing is taking you in deep into a pose and holding you there for long enough, helping you get into proper alignment so that all of the nadis can open, so that all of the energy can begin to flow through. And once you've been in that pose and also being very present with your breath, of course, we will then leave spaciousness for what to do with those energies as they're moving through you. Now, this has been a part of yoga for a very long time, and it is something that in Western culture we've completely ignored while we focus on the physical aspects of yoga, which are very wonderful. It's very healthy for your physical body, but yoga is also meant for your mind and your emotions and your spirit. And so this is really bringing back together the physical practice with the spiritual, with the mental and emotional benefits that come from doing a yoga practice. And it's a very liberated environment. We call ourselves permissionaries, giving ourselves permission to express what comes up, to acknowledge, to be curious about what comes up, and to gain some tools to be able to process that stuff in an environment where weird is completely accepted. So that's pretty much the gist of it. The first classes that we'll be teaching, they'll be offered at Full Lotus Yoga, also known as Karaoke Bowls on Alberta Street, beginning on May 19th. And right now we only have three classes that are scheduled, and you're welcome to register for one or all three of them, and we'll see how it goes, and we hope to see you there. Take care.